Telemann's D minor oboe concerto bears a family resemblance to the E minor concerto I treated last week in that both of these minor key works are organized in the four-movement sonata di chiesa pattern of slow, fast, slow, fast. And both works are homotonal, with all four movements set in the tonic key. Moreover, the final two movements in both instances are connected with a half-cadential bridge. On a deeper level, however, the two works are quite different. The E minor concerto is a model of absolute music of high seriousness, with all four movements exhibiting a formalist architecture admirable in its proportions and detail. But for the D minor work, Telemann has adopted a more theatric posture, and for the two slow movements gives us only a sketch, a melodic outline, which performers would have been expected to elaborate according to their personal taste and idiosyncrasies, thus allowing for a measure of personal creative freedom on the part of the soloist. The artist in this recording, Heinz Holliger, does that very beautifully and always tastefully. The opening movement is a D minor aria for the oboe, a lonely, strangely human voice ferried along by a restless undercurrent of slowly shifting, gently undulating string sound. The solo instrument unfolding its lament as harmonic currents bend it this way and that, the music's placid flow finally checked just before the end for a brief cadenza and the solemn final cadence. The allegro movement that follows bristles with grim determination, its rhythmic profile dominated by a thrusting little dactylic figure that pervades the movement's main theme. Although the ritornello principle is observed assiduously in this movement, the main theme is not so much a theme for the orchestra as for the oboe, so the oboe's role is that of a soloist throughout, ritornello and all. This is, otherwise, in most respects, the most formally conventional of the concerto's four movements. The third movement, only a single paragraph long, is a wonder, a kind of slowly moving, freely ranging aria whose harmonic substrate is among the most restless you'll ever hear, beginning at a harmonic slant, ranging freely in distant chromatic regions, including a breathtaking sidestep onto the dominant chord of F sharp minor about midway through the movement, and finding its center of gravity only at the end, just in time for the Phrygian half-cadential bridge that links to the finale. And that fast movement is just as structurally eccentric as the second movement was conventional. It is constructed in two large parts of roughly equal length, with the first part exploring closely related keys and finally closing in A minor with a tonic major cadence, and the second part stuck doggedly in the tonic key as though determined never again to let it go, hammering its grievances home. That arid description doesn't begin to do this music justice, nor do the things I've said about the other three movements. I find this music surprisingly difficult to describe, yet very easy to love. Perhaps you'll see what I mean as you watch and listen. The performance is, as I've already mentioned, by Heinz Holliger. He's accompanied by the Academy of St. Martin in the Fields, led by Iona Brown.
Thank you. Thank you.